Hello children, welcome back to Social Class. Today we are learning a new lesson from a sociology part, that is a family. First of all, you are already familiar about this name, it's all known. In Kannada we can call it as it is a kutumba. And who is the meaning of family? It is none other than as a group of people. They are living together here as about a related to each other, we can consider here as a family here. As a man, he was a founder as a many social institution. Why he was a founder as a many social in order to fulfill his basic need. In order to fulfill his basic need, he required as a most or more and more an institution here. So it will be there in the society here. So that's what I told that as a man, he was founded as a many other institutions, like about a hospital, like about a family, as about the police station or a school. Like this type, many other institutions we can see in a society. So that's what as a man. Was founded as a many social institution. Why it was started or why it was formed by a man here is in order to fulfill his basic needs. And we know that as a social institution, among that many social institution we are that among that one most important building is another. Family. Among these social institutions, most important one will be, we can call it as it is a family here. Here, almost all as about the activities of the society, as we can consider as a family, we will be it is one of the most important social institution of a society we can consider here. Social institution of a society, almost all activities of the society, it was mainly based or mainly related to this family only. As a member of the family, we can consider it called as the member of the social institution. I hope you are understanding. Think about it is a society. And here, various part of it. As a couple here, we can consider as a school, hospital, police station, market and about a family. Like this type of various social institutions we can consider here. So I hope you are understanding clearly. So that's what I told that as a man, he was formed as a many social institution. Why he was formed here is in order to fulfill his basic need here. In order to get education, he will be go in order to get there as a medicine or go in order to cure up. For that reason, if we go to a hospital and in order to get a safety or a security, the police station will be go and about it, you will be getting as a basic behavior, for the social behavior, everything it will be there in a family. And about in order to purchase something, you will be go to a market here. Among these social institution, a family will be there, it will be called as one of the most important basic institution we can consider. And even though as about I told you that as the the member of the family, they will be considered as the member of the social institution. Hope you are understanding this one. The word family, it was derived from the Latin word that is a familus. Family, it was derived from Latin word familus. What is the meaning of a familus? It is none other than to serve. But the meaning, it is none other than to serve. You already know the meaning serve. To serve or in order to serve, we require some other people here, is all known. So the word is giving the meaning as other members will be there in order to serve a people. So that is, we can call it as a family, as a meaning. So family, it was derived from Latin word, familus. A parent will be called as a family. Various meaning are the children. That's why I know that as a group of people they are living together, we can call it as it is a family. And also we can call it as a system of relationship between parents are called as family. family. And also even we can call it as the other one meaning. That is the husband and wife, they will be only along with their children or without the children for a longer period of time. Also we can call it as a family only. As a family, it will be considered called as it is a unit of society. If it is, it will be a society, it will be called as it is a unit. So family is also called as a, it is a unit. Unit of society. It is a small part we can consider in a society. Various social institutions are there, among that is one, and it will be as a part we can consider. So it will be considered called as it is a unit of society. And also we can also call it as a, it is like a living cell. It is like a living cell. You know that one as a community, it was a development of family here, and also you know that all it was leading the creation of a nation. Without the people, it won't bring a development here. They will do a work and they will earn, they will purchase and they will give to the nation, and it will be considered called as a national income. Through that, it will be given there as a development, we learn there as a work. So that's what they are telling there as a community. It was a developed as a group of people, it will be a developed family one, and also it will be bringing or it was a leading for the creation of a nation. Also we can consider here, and it was a rest on the with the support of an emotional feeling. You know that as a family, it was having the various other varieties of feeling will be there, or various feeling will be there. You know that one as a mother's love, father's affection, and about the love, care, affection. These all we can consider, or we can see in a family. So that's what I told that as a, it will be as a family, it rests on the support of the emotional feeling here. And support in a family, we can see that as in order to take a decision, as a parent they will ask or they will be taking as a suggestion with their children. Sometimes children they require that as a suggestion, they will ask them with their parent or about any other elders in a family. So these all together we can consider, we call as it is a family. Hope you are understanding that as a family. Why it is required also, we just know we learn it. Because in order to fulfill our need, we require that as a various other institutions. Among that, one is the reason of that family. Here, each and everything, starting from foundation itself, it will be given as a each and everything in a family here. Clearly. So, I hope you are understanding about the introductory matter of this family. Now, let's go for characteristics of features of family. What are they here? First of all, you know about it will be there in every society. It won't be seen or about the family. It won't be seen only in some other places. It will be, or it can be seen everywhere. So first one is it is another that family is universal. It is universal. Activities. as a family, it would be considered the god as it is a unit of the society. The side of I draw that as the society in that school, police station, market, family, post office. Like this, the various other institutions will be learned. So, as about it will be your family, it will be considered as a, it is a basic unit of all the social activities here. In order to run or in order to do that the social activities as a family, from that itself it will be required as people. So, as a baby, it was a getting of birth in that family. And soon after, you know, the as about the day after. And then it will be come to a school in order to learn or in order to get an education. And even afterwards, whenever it will be in a position to get it as a or about a occupation, it will be go to a city and there also it will be do a work in order to earn a money. It can be work as a police or about a post office or about in a market. Like there are various varieties of a occupation we can see here. So like this step, as a part of family, it will be considered as it is a basic unit of all the social activity. As a from member from a family, it will they have to go from these all apart or about these all activities has to be done by people only. So I hope you are understanding. It is a basic unit of all social activities. Now let's go for the third one. It is a continuous responsibility.
Continuous responsibility and also it is a
you are willing to have the each and everything, it will be comes from a family itself. If it's a good family, it will be having the rest of good behavior. The child also, it will be learn the same thing. If it is a parent, they are always scolding or about they are having the bad what is the opinion regarding other, it will be followed by a child. Because you know that when as about in order to teach a child, it will be teaching in the beginning itself. Later afterwards, whenever it will be getting the as about a teenage, during that time we taught a child here, means it won't be need to them. So, no. So that's what here they are telling that as the family it was having that as a continuous responsibility regarding the as bringing up and as nurturing a child in order to make that as a good citizen we can consider here. And next one is it is not that it teaches social behavior. It teaches a social behavior. Behavior wise, we know that one. As a good, it is required in a society, it will be considered not as it is a social behavior. How we have to live in a society? We have to give there is a support to others, we have to help them, and we have to show a love and affection to people. Whenever as a good of need, it is required to help, we have to give here, we have to give a respect for our elders. These all are behaviors. But it is required in a society. So these all it will be taught in a family only. So that's what family it will be teaches the social behavior. And that's what is the sixth one. It is the traditions. It is the tradition. You know about a social behavior. They also are the family member, they have to take care of what is right and what is wrong for a child. Yes. So that also can be calculated regarding behavior matter. Now, as a family, it is the tradition. As a family, it will be included there as a several generation here. You know that it is a continuous one. So here we see, we can see as a family, it was including the or it was having the as a several generation, and it was introduced through a kinship. It introduced a kinship. In Kannada we can call it as a Rakta Sambandhi. As about a blood relation, we can consider about this kinship. So family, it was introducing through a kinship, and it was including the as a several generation. Now you know that as about a one generation, two generation, like three generations, like this type, it will be continuous. Yes or no? As like that type only, or like this type only, as it will be teaches that as a basic tradition here. Let's go for that one. What it will be telling that here means, if a family, it was having that as a parent, and their children, then it will be considered as a two generation. One is parent and one is their children. So it will be considered as a two generation. If a family, it was having their grandparent, parent and their children. A family, it was having their grandparent, parent and their children, then it will be considered as it is a three generation. One is grandparent, that generation, next the parent generation, then after their children generation. So it will be altogether three generations. And if it is a family, it was a having as a grandparent, parent, their children, will be considered a as a it is a extended family. Means it is goes on extending this. So it will be considered called as extending family. I hope you are understanding about the definition matter. Just I told you as a family, it was including the as a several generation. Many generation are there. So and even as about it was a bringing or it was introduced through a kinship or about a blood relation we can consider here. And also along with it, you know, as a, it will be teaches the as a basic of tradition here as a, it was having as a family. It was having the as a parent. They are it will be considered called as a two generation. If it is a family who is having the as a grandparent, parent and their children, then it will be considered as it is a three generation family. If it is a family who is having the as a grandparent, parent, their children and also a grandchildren, then it will be considered called as it is a extending family. Please note down in your book, children, and now you may ask the question clearly. So I hope you understand about the all these fixed characteristics or the features in the clear way. So let's go for the A once again. That is a universal. Everywhere we can see. Another one is the equal a basic unit of all the social activities. In order to start a social activity, we require here as a family. So that's why it was called as it is a basic unit of all the social activities. And third one is the continuous responsibility. As a family member, they are having the responsibility as a parent or a grandparent. They are having the responsibility regarding their children. So it is a continuous responsibility and also it is a social accountability. Means they are calculating here how much you want to prepare food and how much they have to give a love and affection to a child here. So these are all it will be calculating here. Clear? And as how many members are there, so it will come. Next one is it was a bringing up and also nurturing. That's the most important thing, children. Because as a parent, they will look after the child in a proper way. The child also will be doing in a proper way. And it will become as a good citizen also. So, and then it will be teaches them as a social behavior here. Because of behavior wise, it is a must for children here. Whenever it will come to a school, you know that as a mother, we are identifying the child through a behavior. So it is required as a almost all a social behavior in order to lead a happy life in a society here. So I hope you are understanding as a family it will teach us that as a social behavior here. Next one is the last one, that is that it was expert in tradition. Culture, tradition, custom, these all it will be taught. Not only about a generation matter children regarding a celebration, regarding the as a tradition which are or about a religion or about whatever the language they are following and whatever the culture it was following by them, everything it will be given by a family member. So I hope you are understanding about the it was a expert the tradition to a child in a family. So these are the important characteristics or features of a family. Now let's go for a types of family. Types of family. Family was mainly based on the geographical position and also communities here. So, and even as a mode, it was basically or it was mainly classified into three types. It was mainly following the nature here. It was classified into three types. What are they here? Means first one is the family based on kinship, based on kinship. Second one is the family based secretary, local resident, and third one is the on the basis of nature of authority, the family. It was mainly classified into matriarchal family and patriarchal family. Authority or about the property right we can consider here, and mainly on the basis of
We can see here property